I create music instruments that have a certain quality in their sound. My feet become roots and just go down and connect to the core of the planet. And I imagine that every blow of my heart is actually permeating, moving, pressing, molding, expanding the metal disc.
It has to be done over and over and over again. It's the sound that tells me where I am and where I need to go and how much more work I need to do. Then once I take it through that stage, I turn it around and whatever I did to expand and bring it back in by hammering on the surface. And through my will force is just permeating the metal with the energy that I'm connecting with through the singing.
I hold the conception and belief and knowledge that there is no part of ourselves, you know, physically at least, that is not part of this planet. We're just made of the same material. In a sense, it's like our essence, some people call it spirit, the source aspect of ourselves is borrowing the material from this planet to have a human experience. So I connect with that energy and I hold this energy, I allow this energy to permeate me because I want the instruments that I create to hold the healing energy of our planet.
Now, once the gong is flat, I just basically turn the rim so it's got a little bit of a curve, and that's the beginning of the tuning process, bringing the sound in and just, you know, making it more contained.
I move from the anvil to a table which has got silica sand in it. So I position a hammer in the center of the gong, and with another hammer I just create a nibble right in the middle of the gong. So what that does is alters the pitch of the core sound of the gong, and it just makes it come to the fore. It's almost like they have spirit, soul, and body. So every gong has like a tonality to itself, which is given by the harmonic sequence that you find within the structure of the sound of the gong. So you have a core tone, then as you move towards the periphery, you have different tones that come in, and then the sustain of the gong, how long it lasts, is more like its physical body.
Also, I listen to the tone. There is a lot of aliveness in the tone, a lot of vibration. So. Essentially, this is almost ready. I need to bake it and then make a holder and a mallet, and then it's ready to go.
After the gong is tuned, I bring heat to it. I bake it. It just crystallizes all the work that I've done, just, you know, solidifies it, encases it within the structure of the gong. And when you play the gong in a space, it's like it really expands and just totally permeates. My passion is essentially of creating something that is in harmony and tuned in with our planet, with our carrier, with what's holding space for us. It is a passion, and it is something that I want to do to be able to feel connected. When I give a mallet to a person and they go to play a big tam-tam that I make, very often the first thing that they do is just take the mallet and they just whack it right in the middle. It's like, man!